So I just recently turned on the solar panel installation that we just installed on our house. Just did it about a month ago, and it was a pain. All sorts of problems, all sorts of issues, headaches, and it was really obnoxious. And the funny thing is, despite all of that, I still don't think that for most people, you'd want to use a solar installer. And I am grateful that despite all that headache, I did not use a solar installer, and I want to talk about exactly why that is. So first things first, about 2 years ago, we had pretty close time proximity, two different people come to our door, knocking on our door, trying to sell solar. And we got a bid from both of them. And I am going to use the information from the cheaper of the two bids for the same size bid. So this is actually the better bid that I got on installing solar. And then I'm going to talk a little bit about some of the discrepancies and some of the favorable math that was done and things that were glossed over and really not discussed that you need to watch out for before you start talking to a solar installer and before you make the decision to have somebody else do it versus doing it yourself. So the first thing is they were quoting me for a 6.62 kilowatt system and they had some incentives. Hey, we'll pay for your first year. We'll do all of this. And after all of that, the total cost for that 6.62 kilowatt system was going to be $28,532. So straight up, that was their bottom line. This is the cost. And they said, hey, however, because it was 2020, because of the federal tax credit, or was it 2019? It was 2019, because 2020, well, we're not counting that year. It was 2019. So the federal tax subsidies at that time would have given us back supposedly $8,560. And first of all, that right there is a red flag. I do not make enough money that I would get that money back. I talked to my accountant about it later, and he said, you know, you can keep it on your taxes, and if you ever make more money, you'd actually get to see that. But with how much I make currently, which I make a decent amount of money, I do have several kids, and that changes the calculation there. But my accountant said, yeah, you probably wouldn't see that for years until your kids leave. And so right there, that was my first red flag, is these guys were saying, hey, immediately you're going to get $8,560 money in your pocket the next time you do your tax return, which is not the case. And so whatever you're doing, make sure you talk to your accountant or you run the numbers yourself before you start believing anybody when they're talking about federal tax rebates and stuff like that. So that was the first red flag. The second red flag was the fact that they quoted me telling me that my average electric bill was $80.37. The funny thing is I actually went back and looked at all of my electric bills that I sent them. I sent them a whole year's worth, and I just took them and did a quick calculation, added them all together, divided by 12, and I got $71. So immediately they were quoting my electric bill as being my current electric bill, average electric bill over the year, as being $10 higher than it currently is, which is kind of strange, but okay, that's, I have no idea where they got from that. But since most people don't have $20,000 to $30,000 laying around, they said, hey, we work with this company that they'll give you a loan, and they quoted the loan at 4.5%. So this $28,532, if we did not have that $8,560 applied to it, it would be $154 a month to pay for the solar panels for 25 years. If we were somehow magically to get that $8,560, it would still be $108 a month for a 25-year loan. Now, to remind you, most solar panels only have a 25-year rated life, and whether or not they actually live that long is debatable, and they are constantly decreasing in their effectiveness over that 25-year life. So already I'm looking at this and thinking, I only have an average of $71 a month per year in electric bills. And now, even if I were to get a federal tax subsidy, which I'm not getting, it would still be around 38-ish, or just shy of $40 a month more for the solar. That doesn't make any sense. And again, considering that I wasn't actually going to get that subsidy, I would have ended up paying $80 a month more for the solar panels, for a 6.62 kilowatt system, which is kind of crazy, especially when you multiply it all out. $154 times 12 months times 25 years actually comes out to be $46,200. So this $28,532 system actually was going to cost me over $46,000, again, for a 6.62 kilowatt system. Now, the reason I keep on bringing that up is because we moved and we got this other house, and we knew that because we switched from natural gas to propane, propane's more expensive, and so we switched over to a few more electric appliances, and so we made a slightly bigger system. Our current system is a 9.7 DC system, or a 7.2 kilowatt AC system, which just means that we undersized the inverters, and I kind of regret it already, don't want to go into it, but that means that we should be maxing out and getting at least 7.2 kilowatts out of this system, and then in less than ideal situation, we should be getting more because the panels themselves are rated for 9.7, again, versus the 6.62. So if you have great installers and they can do it inexpensively for you and do a great job, then fantastic, definitely go with that. They're gonna make your life easier. But whenever you're approached, make sure you calculate those numbers for yourself and get it figured out. Now, if you are gonna do it for yourself, there's a lot of resources out there, so please go check them out. There's resources by people that wanna sell you the parts, and they're gonna be willing to help you with what you need, and you can ask them questions about the design. You have those designers out there that this is what they do. They are used to following the NEC code and providing exactly what you need. So go out and reach out to them. I know for me, it was definitely worth it. If you have any questions or comments, leave it below. If you like this video, if it helped you in any way, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and we will see you in the next one.